So what is business analytics? Business analytics is the use of data to make practical, concrete decisions for a company. So please do understand, when we are saying, I highlighted the word data here. Typically what we do today, most of us apply our emotions and the gut feel. I failed in the examination, or let's assume your teacher who's got 50 students in the batch, he might make an assumption saying, because 10 students have failed, he may make an assumption, these 10 students are not participating in the class, therefore they failed. It's an emotional decision. It is not a data-driven decision. Or he may say, possibly if I had conducted one, what you call a recap session before the examination, maybe all of them would have passed. It's still an emotion. Okay, gut feel. Or he may make a statement saying, if you have done a recap session, whole batch, possibly overall batch average of pass percentage would have been 90%. It's still an emotion, gut feel. It's not a data driven. So therefore, the business analytics states your decision of next course of action purely based on the data, but not anything otherwise than data. So please do understand, in off late, people call data is the asset. Okay, that's the real asset, because based on which business can really survive, business can really collapse if they don't use the data properly. And so is also any of the trainer can do a much better job if he uses the data about the students to understand what exactly is happening with them, and therefore it really helps them perform better. So whole ecosystem, manufacturing industry, let it be education industry, let it be retail industry, talk of industry without basic data analytics or a business analytics, the survival is just impossible. So therefore, the second point comes is the outcome of business analytics, the ability to act based on the insights. Now, I may throw a lot of information based on the data analysis, but can I take a meaningful decision? If somebody, a company head, has to take a meaningful decision, he needs to have some kind of a representation of the data in such form whereby he is able to make a correlation. That is, when I say he's able to make a correlation, he can say, argument's sake, people who take credit cards and whose average monthly salary is 10,000 are likely to default or defaulting. They are not paying on time. So there's a correlation. People who have credit cards whose monthly salary is less than 10,000, possibly they may not pay the payments on time. So there's a correlation. So you are taking one set of value of default, another set of value of the profile, financial profile of a person to figure out, okay, some action has to be taken. So what could be the action? Action is that you may decide not to sell the cards to those people whose salary is less than 10,000, or you may take a better action, because you can't lose the business just by saying I am not going to sell it. That's not the way to move forward. You may take some other very different action, such as saying, okay, we'll send 3 reminders to people who have salary less than 10,000, so that they pay on time. Business you can't lose, but some other action you have to take it. So therefore, the outcome of business analytics is the ability to act on the insights. So that's a very important aspect. And third important thing is business analytics is evolving continuously. Data is gold mine. Data is asset, and data decides what is happening inside the organization. And therefore, amount of decision making algorithms, technologies which are really getting developed in the market will really make the data analytics far more powerful going forward. I use another word here, data science. Right now our topic of discussion is not data science, therefore I am not getting to that, but it's important for you to note down there is a specific domain called the data science. Okay, therefore, business analytics evolving continuously, rooted to solving problems and improving efficiency using combination of data-driven insights, as we spoke just now, and the managerial strategies. Based on the data insight, the management will make a strategy on what should be the next course of action. Now, having taken action, you don't communicate to your people what exactly to be done, it's going to fail. So therefore, we need all three sides to make the business analytics really, really successful. One is you need data, and the data should give insights, and the management should be able to decide what should be the act I should do on that. And more importantly, I should communicate that clearly to my people so that they now change their implementation strategies, then the real outcome will come for an organization. So that's broadly about the business analytics. I'm sure among you, you may have skills which possibly would make you a better business analytic professional. So you may evaluate that, because many of us don't know what kind of competencies we actually carry. Every individual has a very distinct competencies, and exploring and unearthing the real competence in each of us makes a good decision making to figure out what should be my professional career itself.